Who the hell are you?
Huh. You're one of the newbies then. Fine. So long as you know the passphrase, you're in. If not, you're dead. Okay, you're lucky you knew that. Don't know who let you in, don't really care. This is a real simple game. Whoever's the toughest sets the rules. And that's me. And I got just one rule. Do what the hell I say when I say it. Now find a seat. We're waiting for some of the boys to get back. Oh, and put this on. We're a gang. We all wear the same uniform. What is it? Take a seat and relax already. You're making me nervous. No one told you? It's simple. We hit water caravans and stash the Aquapura. And after Rivet City's had enough, we offer our wasteland protection services. Then we control the water. And we charge whoever, whatever we want for it. How do you like that? I'm the boss of this gang. We do what I say. Don't forget that. You got a death wish? Fine by me. Knives, pipes, or boards. Great, here's a combat knife. Use that and only that. I get hit with something other than that or by anyone else, and my boys join in. Good luck. You're gonna need it. Hey!
It's on now! Yeah, man, yeah!
Yeah!
Fight!
Yeah.
Fight!
Yeah.
Fight!
Kill him! Kill him!
You are so... It's on now!
Damn! Kick his ass!
Killed the boss, fair and square. Good job, kid. Normally, that'd make you the new boss, but we're all tired of bosses. But we like Split Jack's plan. So, if you can get that bitch at Rivet City to buy into our protection services, we'll split the take with you. So, we don't need you to be our leader. But we will cut you in on the protection racket. If you can get LaPelletier to sign on.
I had hope.
Hey. Well, did you take care of whoever's behind the attacks on the caravans? Really? That's excellent. Thank you. As soon as I have a moment, I'll make arrangements to see to your reward. Yes, well, I don't really have anything I can give you at the moment. I've simply, run out of resources. Only a quarter of my escorts have made it back. I fear the worst. I'll send word to Bigsley, the Brotherhood scribe running things over at Project Purity. I'm sure the Brotherhood can reward you for your efforts. Now, if you'll excuse me...
I must have been looking at it upside down.
It's all right, sir. I know you're probably exhausted.
Have you ever seen a map? North points up!
Oh, sir.
Try again.
Sorry, sir.
The Brotherhood only accepts the best and the brightest, don't they?
Yes, sir.
Humanity's doomed.
You know, I didn't sign up with the Brotherhood to be an errand boy.
I think I might just not show up. I mean, what's the worst that can happen? I get fired?
There isn't someone else you could bother. I don't know what to think. I got lions breathing down my neck about it, though. Apparently, Megaton's sending him nasty letters demanding a shipment. I just sent them a week's supply. A month's if they ration. Look, if you can straighten out Megaton so I get lions off my back, I'll make it worth your while. Really? That's great. I'm sorry I can't offer you any support in this. All our resources are tied up at the moment. Good luck. Oh, and of course I'll have a little something for your efforts, if you're successful. Stay safe out there. Yes, yes, I received a message from her. It's here somewhere. Well, no matter where it is, I know what it said. The initiates just finished itemizing a requisition of confiscated Enclave gear. There were a few items that we didn't immediately send out. I suppose you're welcome to those. The Brotherhood thanks you for your efforts. Now, if you don't mind, I think I'll just take a brief nap here at my desk.
Have lions forgotten about the war with the Enclave? What the hell are we doing here, really? We have better things to do. Good to see you.
I'm so thirsty.
Oh, poor dear.
Welcome to Megaton. Enjoy your stay.
For me, crystal clear water. Oh, bless you. Bless you.
Oh, bless
welcome.
You.
Megaton.
I haven't tasted water this pure.
Please stand clear of the gate.
Oh, God, what's wrong? Water?
Welcome.
What should I do? He asked for water, and I thought I was helping him, not killing him. I just gave him some water I picked up on the way through Springvale. It tasted pure and it looks clean. How was I supposed to know? I thought it would help him. It was supposed to be holy water. The man at the monastery in Springvale said it was blessed. He gave me this pamphlet along with the water. He called himself Brother Gerard. You could find him on the road through Springvale. They said they had lots of this holy water. Please do something to stop them.
I can't stay here.
Megaton.
Not after something like that.
Please, down, around.
Weary traveler, welcome to the Monastery of the Apostles of the Eternal Light. Oh, but you must be parched from your travels. Yet please, accept this gift. Holy water, blessed by our order. We must drink deep of the water of light, so that it may sanctify our tongues and render us purified for discourse. You must cleanse your tongue of unseemly speech by drinking deep of the holy water. Then we may speak. I can see the glint of Adam's light in your eyes. You have purified your tongue with the holy water. So now we may speak. How may this servant of the eternal light serve you? No, ours is a modest order. But our ranks are growing slowly as others hear our words and are enlightened. As our luminescent mother says, where others walk only in the dying waste, we offer the path of eternal light. And to spread goodwill, we offer this holy water to any and all supplicants. It's full of Adam's light, if that's what you mean. Brighter and warmer than any water I've ever seen before. Blessing of the holy water is overseen by Mother Curie III, our luminescent mother, but her work keeps her busy within the monastery at all times. Our luminescent mother went to meditate outside of the city, and as she wandered in a trance, she was visited by Adam's angels of war. These angels brought her aqua pura. Water so pure, so pristine, and so unsullied that she knew it would make the perfect vessel for Adam's glow. Since that day, she has busied herself consecrating Adam's pure water into the waters of light. No, it's full of Adam's light. It's a tragedy that not everyone is prepared to accept enlightenment, but such are the ways of the divine. Besides, we never force anyone to drink it. We simply give the opportunity to those who thirst for something more. The apostles of the eternal light were first introduced to the majesty of Adam's glow by the holy teachings of Confessor Cromwell. And we were content to stay in Cromwell's church until Adam gave a vision unto our luminous mother. She learned that Adam did not call for division, that sundering which drives us apart. Adam calls for enlightenment, the warmth which feeds us. For it is only through Adam's supreme and total enlightenment that we may attain salvation in eternal light. I am afraid it is not open to the unenlightened. Your presence would contaminate our great works. However, if you are willing to be baptized in Adam's holy light, then perhaps I could allow you to enter and meet our leader. Yes, call it what you will. We simply will not allow any who do not bear the light. Make your way to our tabernacle, pilgrim. Pray to Adam to fill you with holy radiance. Bask in the glow of Adam's eternal light. May Adam's light guide you. May Adam light your path, traveler. Oh, truly your light is second only to the sons of Adam themselves. You are more than welcome. Please, speak with our leader, our luminescent mother, Curie the Third. May Adam's light guide you.
Our world has been barren, and our people have become empty. Their hearts have become dry and cold, and thirst consumes the weak and the strong alike. But we can save them, for Adam's bounty has granted us the gifts of mercy and compassion. Oh my! I wasn't expecting a pilgrim to our shrine. We're hardly prepared for casual visitors, I'm afraid. You must have made quite an impression on Brother Gerard. He's a lovely boy, but rather strident. I hope he wasn't a bother. Oh, but where are my manners? I'm Mother Curie the Third, and I lead the Apostles of the Eternal Light. What can I do for you, my dear? Yes, if you wanted some, I'm sure that Brother Gerard would have gladly given you a bottle or two. We don't charge for charity, you know. It was a gift from Adam. I was meditating, right here in Springvale, when four of his armored angels came to me. When I said I was from Megaton, they gave me barrels of aqua pura and said I should share it with my people. They were very clear on that. Naturally, I understood Adam's message, and so I've been busy blessing this holy water and sharing it with the world. Why, to offer enlightenment to all those who suffer, of course. No more, no less. Adam came to me with a vision. The starving, the ill, the weak, all being made whole and well by receiving the sacrament of Adam's glow. And so, with our holy water, we can make this vision a reality. When exposed to Adam's supreme glow, the ill are reborn in his glowing visage. Those reborn never hunger, never suffer, and never age. All our enlightened brethren need to know is Adam's glow, and they are happy. That's correct, it does. But we can work miracles with our holy water. Free of impurities, this aqua pura is perfect for carrying Adam's blessing. Sadly, only a small number of supplicants truly achieve eternal light. The rest must be satisfied with enlightenment and an end to their suffering. May you know eternal light. Strive for the eternal light. Do you have something you wish to say? Don't be silly. How else will we spread the word to the unenlightened? So many misunderstand Adam and fear the glow of his light as a thing of destruction, rather than humanity's next step toward perfection. With this marvelous holy water, they drink without fear, and by the time the glow consumes them, they have no need to fear ever again. Give it time, child. Soon Adam will enlighten your eyes, and you will come to realize the truth for yourself. I suppose it's a fair question. Ever since I was a girl, I knew I was destined for something special. I always resisted the feeling. Me? Special? But one day I fell asleep during one of the confessor's sermons, and I had a dream. A dream of the prophet of Adam, ablaze with holy light. He told me of my destiny, of my mission. I was called to service, and I answered. The only being able to convince me I was wrong would be the prophet of Adam himself. Why, you are the prophet of Adam! I didn't recognize you until now! Your eyes are aglow. Your very skin radiates with Adam's heat. I didn't realize. My lord, now that you have revealed yourself to me, I do. I see the errors of my ways. Forgive me, for I knew not what I was doing. We will spread your word without the use of holy water. We will return the aqua pura to Megaton. It shall be a test. The worthy will seek us out, and finding us, they will find the message of Adam, drinking the waters of light in their souls. Yes! I leave you now, Lord. I cannot bear to look upon your shining face any longer. My lord, I cannot bear to look upon your shining face. I am unworthy. Strive for the eternal light.
Yes? Cult? There's something about Megaton, isn't there? It's apparently the place to start a cult these days. Guess I can start sending them water again. Hopefully they can keep their grubby hands on their shipments this time. Here. It's not much. Most of the assets have been exhausted, but take this. It's definitely worth getting lions off my back. Thanks. Many of us keep asking that same question. The Brotherhood isn't a postal service. We have important things to do, and we need caps and technology to do it. Lyons is on some kind of mission. Has he forgotten about the Enclave? That's our priority. But yeah, things are being done to offset the cost of Lyons' little pet purity project. Look, it's not that I don't trust you. I know you're trustworthy, but you see, that's just it. I don't think you're capable of discretion. Nothing immoral is going on, but I'm already in a lot of hot water with the Brotherhood. I need to be careful with what I say and to whom. We do what we can. Take, for example, this ghoul Griffin. He wanted to purchase a bunch of water. What the hell does that droopy irradiated fool need with pure water? Thinks he can sell it in Underworld. Moron. But he's the only one who's offered to pay for water in caps and technology. And what Lyons doesn't know won't hurt him. There's plenty of water to go around, and I can use it to pay Rivet City to provide security for all the caravans we can't escort ourselves. Unlucky he came along. Okay, hopefully that's the last distraction for a while.
Though we may seem safe for the moment, I was brilliant.
Better than a fact. It's science. That's terrific. Having trouble seeing? Got a little something in your eye? Rinse it out with the amazing Aqua Cura, and you'll instantly see why it's the only product you'll ever need again. Whoa. Have an oozing sore that just won't go away? Take a clean bandage, soak it in Aqua Cura, wrap it around your wound, and see your skin restore itself in just minutes. Guaranteed. Oh, wow. That sounds great. The amazing Aqua Cura. Not only does it taste great, but it also reverses radiation poisoning. That's right. With each swig of pure Aqua Cura, you're one step closer to being your old self again. Amazing. Simply amazing. The amazing Aqua Cura cures all the common ghoul ailments, guaranteed. More! We want to hear more! Having trouble concentrating? Tired of dry mouth and other side effects of Mentats? Then try the amazing Aqua Cura. Studies have proven that 10 out of 10 drinkers of Aqua Cura do 50% better on all standardized tests. It's a scientific fact. I can't believe it does all that. That's wonderful. Step right up. one and all, and purchase the amazing Aqua Cura. It's the answer to all your problems, guaranteed. Tell us more. Having trouble sleeping? Still, huh? Well, hello there, smooth skin. Step right up. Have you come to savor the great taste of the amazing Aqua Cura? Why? Have you heard otherwise? I changed the name to help ghouls realize its amazing properties. And well, just between us, I've also added a few secret ingredients to enhance the flavor of the original. So it's not exactly the same, it's better. Care to procure a bottle? A free sample, you say? Well, I normally don't do this. But for you, for this one time only, a very special VIP promotional offer. Ladies and gentlemen, ding, ding, ding. We have a new winner in our daily Aqua Cura sweepstakes. Here you go, sir, your free bottle. Step right up in the next 5 minutes and get your very own bottle of the amazing Aqua Cura at half price. Ladies and gentlemen, half price. Are you plagued by hell? Malicious halitosis? I hope there's nothing wrong with your Aqua Cura. Remember, all sales are final. Now, how can I help you, dear returning customer of mine? Really? What's it matter to you anyway? All right, but keep your mouth shut about it. The Brotherhood's happy just giving the stuff away, right? Well, they drove me out claiming ghouls don't need fresh water. Well, big surprise that when I offered to pay for it, next thing I knew, I was talking to Scribe Bigsley, the guy in charge of the whole shebang. Didn't really want to, but on principle, I wanted to prove that ghouls are worth the cost, so I paid him. Now I'm stuck selling this stuff. Good thing whatever they put in it to kill the radiation also undoes the radiation damage to ghoul physiology. Thus, Aqua Pura becomes Aqua Cura. What? That doohickey on your wrist says the water's irradiated? That's a pretty fancy device if it can know something like that. But clearly it's, misinformed. You should get that fixed, because it's definitely giving you false information. Oh, all right. But if you start blabbing, I've got some buddies with itching trigger fingers. So I've got this little operation taking Aqua Pura and replacing it with regular crap. It's not like it'll hurt us ghouls. The Aqua Pura I'm storing to sell back to humans later. You know, raiders, outcasts, etc. The guys the Brotherhood doesn't share with. I'm not a bad guy. I'm just trying to help. The Brotherhood needs me. My caps mean water for the wasteland. Just ask Bigsley at Project Purity. No, not really. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have customers that need my attention. Extreme epidermal exfoliant. It's some face. Or rather, we all had. Welcome back. You're not fooling anyone. Everyone knows you're one of the good guys. But seriously, kid, I'm not up to anything. Just ask any of these fools. I mean, loyal customers. They already see the many benefits of the amazing Aqua Cura. Welcome back. What can I... Well, friend, many would pay 50. But... why, yes. You can't imagine how low the special introductory price is. No, sir. Wrong. Nope. Ding, ding, ding. We have a winner, late. That's right. Right you are. And remember... hellacious, how little busy at the moment, smooth
little busy
skin.
At the moment,
little busy at the moment, smooth skin.
But it's not permanent. Not with amazing...
Yes? Not that it's really any of your business, but we have an arrangement. He buys water, I send him some. I use the caps and tech he pays me to fund the other water deliveries. I send my men with the water to the museum authority on the mall. Griffin sends the payment back with my men. So far, so good. Lions wouldn't approve, but I don't really care anymore. I need the resources, and there's certainly plenty of water to go around. Well, by all means, I'd love to answer some questions. I've got nothing better to do. She apparently decided to pursue more interesting projects up north in the Commonwealth. Real reason? She couldn't handle us scribes improving upon her work. She's the kind of woman who needs to be in charge of everything. Good luck to her out there in the wasteland. It's a long walk to the Commonwealth. Can't say she'll be missed. Because it's not irradiated? Really? You couldn't work that one out for yourself? I don't think anyone really knows the answer to that. Seems... be going rather quickly, though. I'm sure you can imagine the chaos if we just let anyone who wanted to wade into the basin and fill up a jug. Frankly, there just isn't the time or the resources to deal with that crowd control nightmare. You take a bottle, you dunk it underwater, and glug, 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 it fills up. Amazing. But you're right. A machine would help, but all the scribes are busy reverse engineering Enclave gear. A machine that puts water in bottles just isn't on anyone's priority list at the moment. Yeah, well, when you remember what it was you were going to ask, take it up with one of the other scribes, okay? Thanks. What is it this time? I literally can't remember the last time I got sleep. I must have dozed off recently, though, if the, the drool on my desk is any indication. Have a nice day.
Damn!